With over 120 film scores to his name, Hans Zimmer is one of the most prolific artists in cinematic composing. In addition to his prolificacy, Zimmer may be one of the most diverse composers. He has scored everything from animated films to prestige dramas to comic book movies. And he has written some of the most memorable themes of the century. Despite this extreme variety, Zimmer still has his own sound, a sound that is a seamless combination of his many influences. Everything from classical to rock and roll to electronica and even punk rock. Though Zimmer's sound and even his style may change from score to score, he surely makes every film distinctly his own. And he does so not only with his cunning attention to detail, but by drawing on his own personal experiences, putting a piece of himself into the compositions. Zimmer once said that his main goal is to find subtext, to use music to convey the thing they can't elegantly tell in pictures and words. Many more traditional composers simply approach music as background support. A happy scene means happy music to make us feel happy. A sad scene calls for sad music to help us feel sad.
What a cliche.
But Zimmer doesn't approach composing in such a way.
The music is written on purpose in a way that all it does is it doesn't tell you what to feel. It just tells you, it just opens the door for you to come and enter into this world. That's all I'm trying to do is come on in. Be part of our world.
Perhaps this is best showcased with Interstellar. When Zimmer wrote the main theme, he hadn't even seen the film because, well, there was no film. Director and close collaborator Christopher Nolan asked Zimmer to write a theme for a short story he had written.
Why? You're not listening! It says stay!
No, I'm coming back.
When?
The story, fitting on a single sheet of paper, was about a father who must leave his child to go do an important job, something Zimmer could relate to. He took a single day to write the theme, having no clue that it would eventually accompany a futuristic space epic. Zimmer's sincerity and intimacy can be felt in the music. We don't get the cold, distant score so often associated with science fiction. We get something that feels personal. In favor of something more electronic, Zimmer uses organs and harps and woodwind instruments. They lend a sense of warmth and comfort to this sprawling cosmic journey. On a less sentimental side, one of Zimmer's most recognized and unconventional compositions is the theme that he crafted for Heath Ledger's Joker in The Dark Knight. To add a little piece of the character into his theme, Zimmer used a rusty razor blade on cello strings to make this unpleasant screech. The sound not only creates unbearable tension for us as the viewer, but it perfectly depicts the relentless nature of the Joker.
And
why so serious?
To demonstrate just how effective this sound is, let's remove the string elements from the composition and watch again.
Let's put a smile on that face.
And
this moment loses all of its incredible tension.
Why so serious?
As a composer, Zimmer's sound may not be immediately recognizable because his work spans so many genres. I mean, the sound of Sherlock Holmes, for example, is certainly a far cry from something like Rain Man. but all of his compositions are undeniably Hans Zimmer. Despite the extreme sonic variety, Zimmer surely makes the films he scores uniquely his own. Not by making them all sound similar, but with precise detail, unparalleled thoughtfulness, and most importantly, a whole lot of heart.